In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Morning.
Good morning.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have sinned in my thoughts, in my words, well failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my therefore ask all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, on
and
earth
peace.
We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks. We pray, Lord. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Mighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of God, you take away the sins of the world. Christ, yes. You take away the sins of the world. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God, the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our wills to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. We ask this to Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Say hello.
together, to be social, to love one another, and to support each other. Some people think that they are good Catholics because they come to Mass every weekend. Coming to Mass every weekend doesn't make them a good Catholic. What may make us a good Catholic is that we come to Mass, we participate on it, and we are enriched by the scriptures and the sacraments, and then we go forth being a good Catholic, giving up of ourselves to the needs of others, making sure others see Christ first, making sure that our faith is seen in our lives. From this beginning here to the next Sunday, when we need to resupply ourselves, to remember and to remind ourselves that Christ is first. This is why the church emphasizes so much to come to church every weekend, because we need it. We need a constant renewal of what we are and to whom we belong, because we are being attacked constantly every day by others' attitudes, by others' thoughts, what is more important in our lives, our body, our situation, our health, and also many things, that we fail to see Christ in our lives, that we fail to focus in Him. Today, as we continue this celebration, let us give to God what belongs to Him. And may God always bless you. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of my name, substantially and power, through Him all things were made. For our ransom from salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, He was incarnate in the man, and became man. For our sake, He was crucified at Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated right at the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and dead. And His kingdom I have. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord the Divine, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son, the Lord and glorified, who has spoken in the prophets. I believe in one holy and happy apostolic church. I confess one of these is the beginning of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead.
Brothers and sisters, let us bring our prayers to God who hears the cry of the poor.
That the church continue to preach the gospel with power and conviction, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That governments ensure fair taxes and provide needed services, especially for the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That communities work together to end neglect and abuse, especially of children. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who are serving the common good in this challenging and uncertain time, that they will be filled with insight, wisdom, and success in their efforts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the aged, that they will receive the care and support that they need, especially for Mary Jo Dalton, David Forsythe, Betty Festa, Simon Fitzpatrick, Kehlani Palma, Brian Roca, Kyle Butler, Rhea Danello, Katie Holcomb, Linton Noya, Joseph Weber, Laura Lindsay, Robert DeFelipe, Bill McCarthy, and Janet Lucenti. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Nancy Cranville, William Hinchley, and Sister Rosemary Ryan, and Angela Nista, that they may be heirs to the eternal life of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, Joaquin Medeiros, Patrick McGinnis, and Angela Cox Ryan, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we offer in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All power for God, everything we have comes from your hand. We return it all to you, asking only your mercy. Hear our prayers today through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, in eternal God.
For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love in him, by whose obedience you have restored to those gifts of yours that by sin we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy,
God of hosts, heaven and
earth, your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he
who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. We give you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to the setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy this year, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, in whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of it, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once I give you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to the disciples, saying, take this, all of it, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wonder resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, in whose constant intercession in your presence we realize our calling help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pregnant church on earth, with your friend, your servant Francis, our Pope, and let our bishop, the order of bishops, and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of all of us, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself order of your children spread throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are listening to you at their sad passing from this life, give them admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. To Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in thy unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and for by divine teaching, now we dare to stand.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin. And save from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously give peace and unity in accordance with your will, who is and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am worthy to make my joy. Only servant, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, the benefiting from the participation in these heavenly themes we may help, for you have given in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Knights of Columbus, they are selling the luminaries for all this All Souls Day. So those who are interested in, they are outside selling those. The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thank you, God.
Have a nice week all.
You too.